Huatos cultivation. In Huatos cultivation, there are a number of different movements we're going to use of our hands and our arms in order to facilitate changes in the qi. During the entire time that we're doing Huatos cultivation, we're going to be doing the teasing gong element of the lifting upward, the gathering towards the lower dantian, and allowing the breath to sink and mingle with that to help empower this. Now, over this process of working with this, you may discover a natural inclination to do something that's called reverse breathing. I want you to allow this to develop naturally. Don't try to force it. Usually when people try to force this, they actually raise the yang qi a little too much, and it ends up creating imbalance and tension internally. We want to avoid that as much as we can. So allow your breath to be natural until it feels natural for it to reverse in a particular way. What I mean by that is, particularly in the first movement of this, what will happen, because of the way you're moving your arms and your mind intent, you're going to have a natural inclination for the abdomen to pull up and in a little bit more firmly than is normal for the teasing gong on the inhale, and it'll feel like there's an upward movement from the lower dantian into the chest. However, the breath still needs to move all the way in and down to the lower dantian. It'll feel like the physical breath moves down, presses into that dantian, and the qi moves up and into the chest. That is a natural process. You cannot force that. If you try to force it, what usually happens is people do this. And they begin to, you see how I lifted my chest, and they begin to breathe into my chest instead of breathing into the dantian. I still went inward, but that inward kind of condenses and compresses the qi more, and that is very important. So don't strive for this reverse breathing. Allow your breathing to be natural. If there's a feeling of expansion still on the inhale, that's fine. It's more important that the qi arrive at this in a natural way than that it arrives at it. Particular success at it. It will happen on its own when the mind is relaxed, the body is relaxed, the qi is flowing properly, and your mind intent is moving naturally with the action that you're engaged in. So what is that action? I'm going to show the physical movements of each piece of this first, while we're not really doing it as a full qigong, because this is part of the body regulation. So once I have my basic posture, the basic Jian Zhuang, or post-standing posture, where my feet are shoulder-width apart, I'm in the center of both triangles of the feet, I'm soft and buoyant in the knees and the legs, my low back is relaxed and natural, my center is directly underneath the center of my chest, and the center of my head is stacked directly over it, and I can feel that center line from the Hui Yin point to the Bai Hui point at the top of the head. The shoulders are relaxed and drop down. They're not propped, lifted, or pulled back in any way. I'm also not collapsing. Everything is balanced and equal. My weight is equalized. The rotational power of the right and left channels is equalized. And everything is just in a neutral position. Once I have all of that, I'm going to bring my hands in front of and below my lower dantian, palms up. On the inhale, the hands will move upward to the level of the center of the chest. Then they will turn over on the pause between inhale and exhale. And on the exhale, they'll move back down. And they'll turn upward on the pause between exhale and inhale. We don't want this to be too slow. We can make our breath be as long and slow as possible, but you will discover that there is a natural rhythm that enhances the feel and flow of the breath, the mind, and the qi of the body. They'll all unify in a natural rhythm. You want to find that natural rhythm. At first, you may try copying me, but you may discover along the way, as you get into more and more repetitions, it changes, and you're going to discover, from my experience, that every day it changes a little bit, okay? Because your rhythm is a little different every day, okay? And that's part of the art of qigong. All right, so that's the first movement. Eventually that becomes a rhythmic flow. The second one, once we've completed that one, the hands will move out to the sides, they'll turn palm up, and They'll begin at the level of the chest, and they'll move up to the level of the center of the head. They'll pause between inhale and exhale and turn over, and then move back down to the level of the center of the chest. And pause between exhale and inhale, they'll turn back up, and you'll find it to be a rhythmic moving. Now, make sure you're not lifting your shoulders. When your hands go up, your shoulder blades should move down and in. Okay. So this is what that will trying to always get the feel of is that we're moving through a medium, because you are. The air is a medium, and air, in fact, is the medium of qi itself. You know, it's said sometimes that we swim in a sea of qi. It's just like a fish doesn't really notice the water until it's out of it. We don't often really notice the air unless we're lacking it in some way. We want to feel the actual quality of the air and how there is a substantive element. The regulation of the mind, this sequence, when we're moving from lower dantian to middle dantian, we're letting our awareness move back and forth between those two dantians. When we're moving from the middle dantian to the upper dantian and back down, we're letting our awareness move up and down from our middle dantian to the upper dantian and back. We're always keeping a centralized awareness and a teasing gong in the mind, and we're also aware of the whole framework of the body. We're trying to feel the whole being. There's a certain amount of this where we're just truly being very, very present, sort of a mindfulness meditation in motion, where if anything else we're adding to is we're just giving a little bit more for our minds to be aware of in the process. In doing so, we become aware of some subtle nuances and movements in the qi. Then when we come back down and we move up to the chest, we're